Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are, whenever you are. Hello. Thanks for watching my videos. It's Mike. It's December 21st, 2008. I'm going to put some information on the side, as always, should you wish to investigate some of this stuff further. Now, the more astute viewers will have noticed that I'm in a different room. This is because, apparently, a cup of tea and a laptop are usually not best chums when they meet. So Friday morning I had a bit of an accident with my cup of tea. So while I was doing a YouTube protest, and not actually going on YouTube, I actually had an old computer. I dug up an old laptop here, resurrected it, as it were, so I can record these videos. But editing on it is going to be a challenge. However, news today. This is the Daily Telegraph today. Analysts told profit forecast too optimistic. And down there, you can probably see it if I zoom in a little. 91%. 91%. The proportion of sectors across which analyst estimates will have to be cut. Oh, there you go. There's a typo in there. According to KPMG. Now, accounting firm KPMG are basically saying, analysts are significantly out of line with investor sentiment and will have to downgrade their forecasts for how companies will perform by about 30% next year. This is across all sectors of the market. Now, what's going on? The picture right next to it explains. Desperate retailers ring up record discounts. In order to get people in, all stock must go 50% off. So your discount retailers are basically saying, anything to get people in. And the average rate of discount is around 37% this year, which is insane. Now, that's normal you and me kind of people. Here we have on the side of the Financial Times Weekend Edition, luxury retailers resort to secret sales. What's this? Okay, so these are your people that sell you your handbags for $600. You know, you walk in there and you want to buy a silk scarf with a nice print on it, it's going to cost you at least £300. That kind of nonsense. Now, these retailers don't want people to realize that nobody's actually buying this crap anymore at the prices, the overinflated prices that they have. So, what are they doing? They're making, for instance, a secret invite-only discount sessions. So come in, have a nice drink of champagne, have some lovely chocolates, some truffles, and buy some of these scarves. And the discount levels are in the range of 20 to 60%. Now, why are they doing this? Why are they doing it in secret? And they've also set up internet websites where you can, you know, go and buy this stuff on the internet at a cut-down price. Why are they doing this? They are too posh to have sales, effectively. But their stock is building up dramatically, and they need to get rid of it. They need to shift it, or they'll go out of business. What's going on, people say? Financial Times, weekend money. Drop in demand is chief concern. Okay, so small businesses are basically shouting out here. They're talking to the Center for Business Research, and they did a survey of some of these small businesses. Small businesses are most worried about consumer demand drying up. People don't want to buy the stuff they're making, they're manufacturing, whatever they're doing. Much more than the fact, I mean, only 6% say they are having difficulty getting loans or getting their overdrafts changed, things like that, by the banks. No, what they're worried about is people like you and me not actually buying the stuff. Okay. Last couple of things, analysis. What spooks me is not deflation, but the Fed's foolhardiness. He's spooked. Liam Halligan. Okay, so basically he starts off by explaining why the dollar went up all of a sudden from, you know, September onwards until just basically a couple of weeks ago. Why was the dollar climbing so much? Well, investors are getting freaked out. They're taking their money out of the markets. They're taking their money out of all markets all over the world. And they're dumping it in U.S. dollars, U.S. treasuries, whatever. Anything they can get a nice safe harbor to put their money in. Now, the problem with this is the Fed has decided to use what's termed quantitative easing, which to you and me basically means let's fire up the printing presses and let it fly, boys. Start firing this money everywhere. Okay. In a deflationary cycle, that's okay. All right? You can get away with it. What you need to do is then turn it off at the end of the deflationary cycle and say, okay, enough, and rein in the money supply. Now, the problem is, right now, we have a deflationary cycle, but not on all goods. Okay, some goods are reducing. Obviously, your rents are reducing, mortgage costs are reducing, because housing prices are dropping like a stone. Oil and gas is dropping as well. So if you heat your home with gas, then you know your heating costs are going to decline. If you're filling up your car with gasoline, petrol, diesel, whatever, the price of that has dropped. We have deflation of some of these things. What isn't deflating, and is actually inflating, are the core goods. Things like vegetables, they're up 12% this year. Dried goods, flour, rice, they're climbing. It's next to impossible to get basmati rice, which is an Indian kind of rice. It's quite nice. Next to impossible to get it. Because it's basically being used by the Indians. So, all these things are inflating. All the stuff that people are actually buying right now is inflating. The stuff that people aren't buying much of, things like gasoline and petrol and diesel, people are cutting down all these journeys. They're not traveling anywhere. Jets are flying nowhere near as frequently. Cars aren't being bought. I mean, car sales have dropped like 40% in the last 3 months here in Britain, and a similar figure in the States. Hell, even Volvo can't sell their big trucks. Volvo own Mack trucks. They own a couple of other trucking companies, truck manufacturers, and they're actually having more orders cancelled than new orders coming in. So they're freaking out. So all these things that are, you know, high cost, high value, nobody's buying them. And those things are deflating. Now the things that are essentials, these are inflating. So if you start firing up the printing presses, while your essentials are inflating, you are effectively creating a big bubble, which could result in the currency falling to pieces. Now, if we look at this, it says so right here. Any fundamental view of the dollar depends on one's opinions of the Fed's strategies. Will the zero interest rate policy help the US economy, or will it make matters worse? Well, Liam here says, I ascribe to the latter view, and I fear an outright collapse in the dollar. Okay, so this isn't just you and me. The dollar is going to tank in a big way. How far will it go? No one knows. Right beside it, we have, of course, Ambrose Evans Pritchard. Protectionist dominoes are beginning to tumble across the world, he says. Right, so there's riots going on in China. There's riots going on in India. India, they managed to kill the manager of a factory that was closing. The Chinese are up in arms. All the factories are closing. Nobody's creating any toys, manufacturing this garbage to send over to North America and to Europe. You're going to have civil unrest in these countries, and it's already starting. Greece, the riots in Greece basically started out as a protest against the shooting of a teenager. They are still going on. And now they've shifted into different focus. The Greek economy is not the strongest economy in the European Union, and they're already seeing difficulty in getting food to people. They don't tell you that on the news, do they? No, sirree. They don't want to freak you out. Last piece, very quickly, because I'm running out of time. Front page of the Sunday Telegraph. Over on the side there. Can you see it? Outbreak of flu is worse for 8 years. Britain is in the grip of the worst flu outbreak for 8 years, with the emergency services fearing they will be swamped by calls when GP surgeries close for Christmas. So basically all the general practitioners here, the doctors, local doctors, are closing their offices for 4 days over Christmas. And the accident emergency departments, you know, your emergency hospital emergency departments, are freaking out. They're already having, you know, cases where they have to back up, offloading people off the ambulances because they can't get them in fast enough. This is how serious it is. You're not going to see this on the news either. The last time this happened in 2000 and 2001, NHS, the time of the millennium when crematoriums were first forced to work around the clock. Crematoriums working around the clock to cope with the 22,000 people that died. So this was 8 years ago. This year will be much worse. Why? Because people aren't as healthy. It's very simple. You usually get sick if you're not healthy. And if you can't get the right food, and the food that you are eating is not healthy, you are more likely to get the flu. Okay, folks, don't panic. Panicking gets you, just makes you crazy. Don't panic. Relax. Think about things. You'll get through this fine. Peace. Understanding. Love. We'll see you through this. Cheers, folks. Everyone have a great day. Have a good weekend. Let's see if my laptop will let me edit this thing. Bye.